Hi all, this is a tutorial to talk about ThinkCalc and how you can use this software. So when you unzip the folder that you have downloaded, you will click on the executable. You can always create a shortcut in your desktop. So this is the main program. You can fix here so that you can see all the parts of the program better. Okay, so the program has these five main tabs. In the first tab, the general tab, you select what you want to analyze. Is it a cross-laminated timber beam? Is it a glue-laminated timber beam? Or is it a solid timber beam? Below, you can select the design code. We have implemented the UE Code 5 and the Italian National Standards of 2008. You can select the load duration for the accidental load. We have just one type of accidental load. You can select the service class and the category. You can also select if you want to consider or not the Scacchera effect. So what is the Scacchera effect? It's simply for multi-span beams, you can have various combinations for the accidental load where you apply it in some spans and in others you don't apply it. So when you click this option, the program will analyze all these various combinations and will take the worst case results. Here you can select the formation limits. Usually they will depend on whether it's a primary or a secondary component, or and you can always impose your own limits. So for a CLT beam, we just have for now a generic producer, and here you can see all the list of the CLT panels configurations that you can select. Keep in mind that you can use also the wheel of the mouse to browse through the various CLT panels. You can see the thickness of the layers, and here you can always see the cross section. You can analyze a horizontal panel or you can analyze a vertical panel. For example, beams, CLT beams above windows. Usually for the horizontal panels, we analyze floor CLT panels. And you can also select whether the external layer is parallel to the beam or it is perpendicular to the beam. And you can see always here that the cross-section is adjusted. For glue laminated or solid timber, you will have the Eurocode compatible strength classes, and you have to select the width and the height. You can always modify this with the wheel mouse, and you can also consider or neglect the kappa crack factor that is related to the shear resistance of the cross section. Now you can also perform fire design verification. So when you click here, you will have to input how many minutes is the fire scenario that you consider, and you have to select where does the fire comes from, usually from the base. You can see here the chart cross section, while in the minutes of protection layer you can consider the effect of protection layers that can reduce the exposure to fire. So you can see, for example, that we can have a cross section like this. Let's select CLT. Okay, so this is what relative to the first tab, the general tab. So now let's go to the second tab that is related to the spans. Here you see we have a single span. You can consider up to six spans. For example, we input three spans. You can either change the length of each span, as you can see always here that it is updated, or you can select the cumulative length. For example, I can do something like this, and I can have a three span length. Regarding the supports, you can have you can select how is the support compared to your actual case. You can also select if you don't have any support, you can have all the support and everything, all the various possibilities. While this number here is related to the length and the width of the support that will give us the area for the verification for loads perpendicular to grain, compression perpendicular to grain that comes from the reaction. Okay, so now we go to the distributed loading. Here we're going to input the loads that are beam sustains. We have a permanent load G1 relative to structural components, permanent load relative to non-structural components, and accidental load. Typically for a CLT floor panel, this will be zero, but then everything depends on your case. So let's say here that we put 2 kilopascal, and here we put also 2 kilopascal. We have one meter of tributary width. These are now constants for all spans, but they can also be different. So for example, if I have a cantilever, maybe I want to use a different volume for each span. We can also have different tributary width for each span, which can be constant. So you can see always here how everything is updated, but it can be also trapezoidal. So for example, like this, or it can be also 3-point trapezoidal. So you can have also something like this, where here you can control also where the midpoint is the midpoint. So this is regarding the distributed loading. Now, regarding the concentrated loading, we can consider up to 12 concentrated loads. So let's go and select one load. Here we're going again to put the values for the permanent structural, permanent non-structural, and the accidental load. And then with the distance, we control where the load is compared to the left edge of the beam. You can see here the range. Now, if the span number is zero, it means that the accidental load will always be present with no dependency on the option of Tucker effect. Instead, if we want to declare that this load is part of a certain span, for example the second span, you can see here that the range changes just in this span, then when we have the Tucker effect activated, this load will follow the accidental part of this load will follow the various load combinations. So if there is accidental load in this span, then there will be also the concentrated load. Finally, the vibration design, we have these are the parameters, but for now I do not say much. You can always play around, and we will soon have a tutorial to explain more about the vibration. Once we have configured all this, we can go and save our file. So let's say that we save as a test file. Yes, I'm going to substitute it. No, okay, I'm gonna put a new name. It's okay. Test file 2. Save. And now we can run the analysis. Okay, so as we run the analysis, we go on this panel and we can browse the results. We can see for the permanent loads, for the ultimate limit state, in this case for the CR and for the moment, we have different load combinations due to the Skakia effect, as we said. We can see the displacement, the deflection, and the deflection over the length ratio for each span. And we can even we can see also the deflection at the infinite time. These are the results for the fire combination, and here we see the actual loads without any load factors, whereas the load factor that we have are summarized here. We can also see the normal and shear stresses for the permanent combination, for the ultimate limit state, for fire, where you can see that is non symmetric, and for the actual case. And here is the verification. So the summary of the verifications, permanent loads, ultimate limit state, the serviceability, the verification for compression perpendicular to grain at its reaction force. And here you will see if this will be also always updated to show you if the beam pass all the verifications or not. For example, here we see that the visibility limit state does not pass. If we increase the panel, probably we will be able to pass all the requirements. Yes, okay. Once we run the analysis, we can also click this icon to print the report in a rich text format or RTF. By clicking there, you will have in your in the same folder an RTF file with the same name as your main file name. And here you can see a summary of the input results and a summary of the input and a summary of the output with all the diagrams, all the verifications laid out. And of course, all this is editable, so you can copy paste it in your Word report as you prefer. Okay, we'll close this. So that's it. With all this brief tutorial has come to conclusion. Thank you for watching, and we will be back with more tutorials on more specific subjects. Thank you very much.